Hey everyone, Reid here with Valor Ridge, and the purpose of today's video is to talk about why I choose the AK-74-47. I just did a recent video about the AR-15 and why I like that one, and I know that the AK is a rifle that has been growing in popularity for about the past 14 years in the United States, so let's go ahead and get started. One of the biggest reasons why I choose the AK is because, number one, it's durable and it simply works. A good quality built one, it's going to work. I'm talking about guns like Rifle Dynamics, Krebs Custom, some Arsenal ones out there. A well-built one will work. And you can even get some of those guns, those Norinco MAC-90s, if they're still available. I don't know if they are. I know a lot of them are drying up, but those guns flat out work. You're gonna have a gun that's gonna last your lifetime and probably your children's lifetime. So durability is one of the most important aspects of a rifle that I look for, and the AK rifle most certainly fits that criteria. Another reason why I choose the AK is because it's accurate enough. And is it as accurate as an AR-15? I would say some AKs are as accurate as some AR-15s. They're not as inaccurate as people make them out to be. I think a lot of the bum rap for the AK rifle comes with people that simply don't understand how to zero the rifle to begin with. They buy it from a store, they buy it out of a used deal or something like that, and it's simply not zeroed out of the box. So then they try to shoot and aim it, and it doesn't hit where it's supposed to hit or where they think that their front sight was. A major problem with this rifle is people don't know how to zero it. Once you zero these rifles, I'm going to tell you this, that I have personally never fired one that shot less than 4-inch group at 100 yards. And that goes across the board from quality all the way up to premium grade ones. I personally owned Wassers, I've owned Arsenals, I've owned the Rifle Dynamics and the Krebs, and across the board, I've never had one shoot less accurately than 4 inches at 100 yards. And I think when people's mentality about accuracy, especially in the United States, is kind of skewed. If you've got a rifle that'll shoot 4 inches at 100 yards, that means an 8-inch group at 200 yards. I'm talking worst case scenario. I'm talking about a four inch rifle at 100 yards. That's on the outer edge of the accuracy of the AK. Most of them will shoot tighter than that, especially those 74s. So I found that a 4-inch group at 100 yards, more than adequate to do the job at any realistic, reasonable self-defense range or even any realistic combat scenario. You know, if we're talking a 4-inch group at 100 yards, you double that out to 200 yards, that's 8 inches. That's right up in here. That's high center chest or right in the vitals of somebody. And if we take that out even to 300 yards, that's 12 inches. That's about the size of a dinner plate, folks. So if you can hit a dinner plate size target out to 300 yards with a rifle, I would say that that is most certainly suitable accuracy for self-defense or for combative use. So our expectations about accuracy when, you know, we're sitting on the bench and we've got the sandbags viced in and we're, you know, got everything else going on, that's unrealistic. That is not how we shoot these rifles when we're shooting for self-defense and defense of others. We're in field positions, we're in the prone, we're in the kneeling, we're in the standing. So all that stuff needs to go away about, oh, I won't get a rifle unless it's a 1 or 2 inch group at 100 yards. Well, sorry to say it, but most shooters out there can't shoot that. And if you can shoot a 2-inch group at 100 yards, then you should go to Camp Perry and win trophies, because national champions shoot 2 MOA. Another reason why I choose the AK rifle is because it's easy to use. There's minimal controls on it. When you're talking about functional on the rifle, when we're actually using it, we have the safety and we have the trigger. And with the magazine release right here, that's an easy fix. So the rifle is excellent for simplicity to use. You can train somebody to use it very quickly. It's not many controls at all. A lot of people will say that it's not ergonomic, but I don't understand that, because they never ever said that the M14 wasn't ergonomic. They never said that the M1 wasn't ergonomic. It's the same controls. It's a rocked-in magazine with a right side reciprocating charging handle. Very simple. So these are the same attributes that many positive rifles that are viewed in the United States have. I like it that it's simple to use. I like that you simply rock the magazine in and rack the action and the rifle's ready to go. It's simple, it works, it's easy to take apart, it's easy to clean, it's easy to put back together. And if you compare it to the AR-15, which one would you rather take apart and put together out in the field where there's grass or mud or puddles of water? I can tell you straight up that the AK's got much bigger parts, they're easy to put together, and it's a very, very simple rifle to use overall. Not dogging the AR-15, I'm just saying that this rifle here, this AK, is a very, very simple, ergonomic rifle to use. And you may have to speak a little bit of Slavic to it to get it to do what you want it to do, but that's not a problem. Another reason why I choose the AK is because of the open sights, folks. Now, a lot of people will say, oh, these open sights aren't as accurate as the peep sights on an AR or any other rifle. Well, that may be true, but up close, when we're talking room clearing distances, when we are talking buildings, or when we're talking shooting 50 yards and in, I like the open sights. I like how it's an open tangent rear sight and that standard front sight post. I like that. Why? Because it gives me the same sight picture as my pistol, and I don't have to mentally process that. I'm used to looking at those open sights. I'm used to looking at a rear sight notch with a front sight put in there. There's very little changeover mentally between a tangent sight picture, which is what the AK rifle has, and between your pistols. Very easy to use. And up close at those close ranges, 10, 7, 5, 3 yards, it is lightning quick. In fact, I would say it's just as quick as a red dot, and I've timed this. I've put it on a timer between a red dot and an iron sights on those close shooting, and there's no difference. I mean, there's literally no difference in time. So that's another benefit. So y'all out there looking for a home defense rifle, and you don't want to spend a bunch on equipment, or you don't want to change your sight picture from your pistol to another gun, this is a great option for you. I really like those open sights, and we can get rounds into somebody very, very rapidly, very quickly if we need to. Love the open sights on the AK, especially at those up close distances. Another benefit to this rifle is the ammunition. I mean, we're talking 7.62 by 39 in those 47 variants, and we're talking 5.45 by 39 in the 74 variants. Now, we don't have as much ammo choices as we do for an AR, folks. That's just common knowledge. We do not have the ammo choices for home defense or for self-defense. However, in the 30 cal version, there are options that I think are very effective that you could use, at least much better than ball ammo for your home defense. We're talking 8M3. That's a hollow point version. Penetration is substantially less than some of those ball rounds out there. There's even some soft point versions out there that penetrate substantially less than the ball. So look at some of those. Test them out in your gun, make sure it works reliably. Some guns, the gun doesn't like the hollow points, and some guns don't like the soft points. But if that's the case, you can also go with Hornady SST. That is a polymer tipped. It's got a red polymer tip on the front of it, and it helps feeding in some of those rifles that may not like those hollow points or those soft points. So that's another option. So we really don't have too many options in 30 cal, but we do have a handful of them, and I'm sure one of them will work for you. Regarding the 5.45, once again, limited ammunition availability simply because we don't have the makers in the United States that focus on that kind of ammunition as opposed to overseas where they do. You know, especially with the surplus ammo regulation by the ATF that really dried up a lot of the 5.45, cheaper 5.45 ammo. Well, we still have options. Hornady makes a good option in that 5.45 for home defense, and I would definitely go with that over any of the other loadings. But they're both effective rounds. 7.62 by 39 is a great round. It's been proven over the last 7-8 decades. You know, we also go with the 5.45, which has been in service since the mid-1970s. So their reputation as fight stoppers on the battlefield is not in dispute. It has been used effectively in many continents across the world. Both calibers have 7.62 by 39 and 5.45. That is a non-issue when it comes to asking, geez, I wonder if the AK round is an effective round, because that question has been answered millions of times over. Another benefit to the AK rifle is its long life, and its parts seem to last longer than the AR parts. For example, barrels, bolts, magazines, receivers. This rifle here started life as a Mac 90. You can see from the smooth receiver that it didn't have the optic mount that some of the rifles do, but this rifle started as an original Mac 90. I can't tell you how many rounds I had through the original rifle, but it was a lot. I would say probably 4 to 5 times more rounds through it than an AR would go without having to replace the barrel or the bolt or anything else like that. The rifle just lasted. This rifle here just got redone by Rifle Dynamics a couple of years ago, and a new barrel on it, and of course the original bolt still in there. They just re-head spaced it when they put the new barrel in. Same receiver, same everything, and it works just fine. So you're gonna have a long life rifle when you go with an AK. You will not have to replace the parts as often as you do for an AR-15, and I know that's important for some of you out there. So a consideration to take into account when you're selecting a rifle. And one of the last reasons why I really like the AK rifle is that it's easy to put a light mount on it or an optic mount. Some of the rifles will come with an optic mount here on the side of the receiver. I do not like those. In fact, I've never seen one that held zero in any one of our classes, not one time. It's either wobbled loose, shifted zero, or something's gone wrong with it. And when you couple that with the fact that the receiver of the AK flexes very violently during recoil, that may not be the best option to mount optics for you. What you can do is have an Ultimac rail here. They're less than $100, maybe $106 shipped. And you can now what you have is with an option that simply replaces the gas tube on that AK, and you instead of that original gas tube, what you've got is your railed slots where you can put a white light, or if you prefer, you could put a red dot on there. Be careful though, you're gonna have to get a durable red dot because this does heat up very much so, and some of those lesser quality red dots will most certainly get fried. I have put an aim point on here and I have put 5 or 6 straight magazines at a pretty decent clip through it, and the optic still worked, still held zero, and it didn't shut off, so very durable. And I couldn't really see a situation where you'd go through that many magazines in a row, but we did it just to make sure that the optic would hold up under sustained use. But a very simple option for you if you have your AK and you don't know how can I put a light on it, how can I put a red dot on it, I would like those things, but the original designed rifle doesn't allow me that option. Well, an Ultimac rail most certainly does offer that option for less than $100. So I know it's extra cost on the rifle, however the capabilities that it gives you is much more worth the cost. So just some advice, and if you are looking for to mounting something on your AK, that's what you can do. Now the AK is not as we can't really outfit it as easily as we can with an AR-15. AR-15 offers you a lot of options, but the AK, really, what would you need on it? You need a white light, and if you prefer to run an optic, you can run an optic, that's fine, and that provides that option, but you do have to buy an extra component to that rifle. So something to keep in mind, but my favorite setup for an AK is just like this, with an Ultimac rail, white light, and a red dot on there. So just some advice for you, and one of the reasons why I choose the AK. And of course, the final reason why I choose the AK rifle is because it's been proven for decades. We're talking mid-20th century that it's been around. It's been in combat use across the world. Probably the most prolific rifle in the world. And it's decades long proven track record of success, durability, and accuracy is one of the most convincing arguments for me why I use an AK rifle, why I prefer it, and why it will always be in one of my options, one of my go-to options for when I need a firearm to save my life. If you found the information helpful, subscribe to the channel, folks. And if you want to support my work via donation by Patreon, that link is down below there as well. And more importantly than anything, if you want to learn how to use your rifle, whether it's an AR, AK, or anything else, come on out to Valley Ridge and we can do just that for you. This is Reid Henrichs of Valley Ridge reminding you, the lessons that we learn are written on the tombstones of others. We'll see you on the ridge.